Hello. You're not tired. Good. So actually, I'm not here to talk about the Cirque du Soleil or anybody else except TED. So TED means technology, entertainment, and design, right? TED? How many of you knew that before I just told you about TED? All right, yes. My parents sent me, and I don't know why. So technology, entertainment, and design. So the reason that we even mention the words the Cirque du Soleil or the Franco Dragone Entertainment Group in Belgium is because what has happened over time in a certain kind of entertainment is that the technology and the design have combined in an artistic fashion that allows the entertainment to change form. What I mean is that in the old days, like my old days, the artistic idea would have a technical support, or there would be a design idea, but the technicity and the design wasn't part of the actual idea. Yeah? So now we've gone into things where entertainment has changed enormously because of this. And I will actually allow myself to draw a slight distinction between entertainment and theater. Because entertainment has a theatrical element, but it's very difficult to take something like The Tempest or Sommernachtsdroom and then to bring in a spaceship, okay? So we have to protect theater from too much technological influence, in my opinion. So before I would like to show you a video, which we have ready, which is going to illustrate what happens when you take a high level of technology and a high level of design and you combine it into the concept of the entertainment. Voilà.
Really, Franco painted this dream world around us, and I saw this idea of a house made of water.
When I called to try to explain this project, I think the people, they don't believe me.
You have to have a vision, not idea. You have to have a vision coming from deep from you, you know, and you express it.
The City of Dreams does not necessarily need to have a project which is ambitious as this one. And the meeting of these two men has been a mutual investment in artistic production. Lorenzo, he has made an amazing investment in this. And so as an investor, I'm very happy that he's invested as he is. The challenges have been enormous, and he's been right there.
The top of the top of the top of the list, it's Lorenz. Lorenz O, my friend and partner, because he is supportive. At first he wanted this, and he's supportive until the end of the process, which is fantastic.
Put together a cast of 80 people. They come from 25 different nationalities.
Extremely difficult because the athletes, they are all shaped the same body. Some are dancers, some are acrobats. The most important muscle for a performer is imagination.
If I could be inside that brain, I can't be. I can only sort of throw ideas at him and then let him. His imagination is so insane, and then he goes so far beyond.
So we're in that state of maybe, that state of suspense, where the breath gets held at the top. That moment
That moment is pure beauty.
This is completely different to any other show, because normally you move into an existing theatre, put the show in, yeah, do the rehearsals and everything, and then it's a theatre that's already running. This is a building built to put a single show in. I mean, I don't know if that's ever been done before.
It is, we call it a water-based show. Well, because there's a pool, but there's also a stage, which is dry, and there's also the air. So if you look at the cross-section of the theatre, the water comprises one-third of the building.
This is a very hostile environment, you know, up in the air, underwater, it's very hostile. So we need to have all the people everywhere to take care of the security of everybody.
The grid on level 6, where we load from, and then you see the platform move out from underneath you and you're looking down, it's very high. It's scary. 5, 6, 7.
The acrobats have a different mandate. They are at such a level of elitism in their performance art that it becomes a question of life or death if they're not paying attention.
Safety is paramount for whatever we're doing. We're doing very dangerous things. And the other really big thing is that if you feel unsafe or you're not sure about something, you don't do it. You stop.
Well, level 5, we have a cruciform. You've got 40 winches. On top of that, we also have vertical winches that go up and down, and there's various types. There's pieces for people to fly out on. We have some high-speed winches. Some of these go up to 8 meters a second, so we can really have people just fly out. We can also bring them in. Looks like they're coming in a free fall.
Downstairs, we have a system of hydraulic hoses, pipes, and pumps, electric pumps. They are some of the largest in the world, those pumps. They are used for aircraft carriers to launch jet fighters. The lift system, it's consisted of mechanical and hydraulical platforms. They operate up and down. The center lift can lift about 65 tons, and the other lifts can lift about 25 to 30 tons of weight. And they can catch people under and crush them.
The fountain system got 63 pumps, feed by 400 volts. The nozzle, who goes at 17 meters, are quite powerful and quite dangerous. The issue was really to design the system protecting the performers.
The new style I view is Mamma Mia, where I am. You know, where I am, you don't know what is this, you know? I don't know if I have to come back to Spain, you know?
Come to see, come to see.
The show will tell this to the audience. These people are feeling good together. It's a kind of sub-language that exists in any human collective adventure.
You know, if you can bring a little of happiness in everyday life of people, it's great.
So that's not to necessarily encourage you to go buy tickets and come. But what it is to show you the idea that that much technology and that much design is a result of this kind of entertainment product. So to go a little bit more to you, but the difference is all that technique has to be vision driven. One of the men who was speaking, he said, you cannot just have an idea. You have to have a vision. The vision is a much longer term and a much more broad idea. An idea does not communicate from one person to the next the way a vision does. And if you have to communicate somehow with 450 people over a 3-year development stage, it's going to need to have a Nokia. No, it's not going to have a Nokia. That's communication, connecting people. No, if you're going to communicate with 450 people to develop that over a 3-year period, you have to have vision that drives the technique and drives the design. Can you please show this one? So this, just as an idea, I talked about the theater being a technical environment. This is 5 Olympic swimming pools of water, 17 million liters of water. We have all of these lifts that go up and down that allow it to be a water environment or a, sorry, stable environment, more stable than here. And then all of this, and all these people have to come in. Imagine, you're coming in from taller than 25 stories, and you have to trust, like he has to trust to know that what they told him about sharks actually works. Well, when you have a great white coming here, you better study, and you have to have the right reflex. Whereas when you're in a situation and you're going off of 25 stories, 45 meters, you cannot pull back. It's dangerous. The same thing when you're under the water. If you decide, oh, I'm afraid, and you just go up, it's dangerous. So what we have to do is remember that all of this technique is there to serve an artistic thing, and it's about people. Because we see a machine that big, and we forget the most important thing, which is the people. So can you now just take whatever photos there are and just let them go through so they can see that? So what I call about the human machine. You saw the guys, the divers. The divers have to actually accompany people that some people don't even know how to swim. We brought 13 people from Tanzania who'd never been in a swimming pool. And we brought them together with a dancer from China or with a Brazilian high diver. 90 people in the cast. There are 250 people every day that deal with that environment. So what we have to do is create not only the technical environment, but the human machine. And we do that not by training, but by education. Madame, s'il vous plaît. There's a difference between training and education. Training is short-term and education is long and deep. So what we try to do in an environment like this is to create an environment where the human machine is done through education and not by telling people what to do. Okay? That's the way we do that. So then we have the fact that we have 450 people doing this show. And then we have 2,000 people in the audience watching the show. So no matter how much technology there is, and no matter how much design there is, in a situation like this, we have to remember that it is above all a human environment. And to retain that is one of the biggest challenges that we have. So one of the things that I would like to point out, if we could just, we don't need to see me, can we just lower the light a little bit? On me, thank you. So you saw the motorcycles. These guys are driving motorcycles in an environment like that. Most people that do freestyle motocross don't have to evolve in an environment like this. So the cultural aspect is not just the dancer from China and the artist from Tanzania. It's taking a motorcycle guy and telling him, you have to be on time, you have to not drink too much Red Bull, and you have to actually drive your motorcycle in a theater. So the cultural stretch is much more than a question of nationalities. And it's also for us that we don't just tell everybody what they have to do because they are our language. So as much as the technique serves the concept, the people in the thing are the ones that actually become the base material. And one thing that I wanted to say to those of you that are studying is that now you are lucky. You're going to school and people are teaching you. When you go longer in life and you're no longer in school and people are teaching you, when you want to learn something, you're going to have to go and get it. It's not going to come to you. So the best thing you can do for yourselves now in your lives is go for a degree of excellence. Go for expertise, but educate yourself as wide as you can by curiosity and passion. Because the more you know about different things that are not necessarily practical, it will help you maybe be part of a design team that will be on Mars One, maybe in Macau, or printing things in 3D. These things are important. So whatever you do, please be inspired and thank the people from TED that have the passion to bring to you technology, entertainment, and design. Thank you. Questions? You understood everything. Fantastic.